Hello and welcome back to the Battle. My name is Colin, and today I've got a very special team for you. So I know it's been a couple days. We've been I took a little break from YouTube, but we're back now. We're back into the constant uploads. We're actually going to change the upload days, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, just so you guys know. This will obviously be the first one, but enough about that. We're here for the team. So recently, I would say recently, like 2 weeks ago, there was a tournament that was won by Frostmoth. So this is a team that I've used before. It's very similar outside of the Frostmoth, which I think is a big change and something that demands a lot of attention. It's a completely different Pokemon. So the player, I'll link you to their article that they wrote. They wrote like a little Google Doc article about the team, how it functions. Shoutouts to them. They love Frostmoth and they've found a lot of success with it. It's like their favorite Pokemon and they just started using Frostmoth to succeed, and they ended up winning a quite sizable online tour. They've only been playing for like a year, so yeah, it's a pretty cool team, and I thought we'd feature it on the channel and play with it because I do think the Komo-Ting Lu stuff is really fun, let alone with Frostmoth. So let's just get into some battles. Again, all their stuff is linked below, including a paste to the team and also the team ID up there if you want to try it out on the ladder yourselves. All right, so we've got ourselves a rank 2000 opponent. We've got the King Gambit gouging fire shenanigans stuff. Well, Komo goes crazy here. We might not be able to show off Frostmoth too much here because Komo is the goat here, but yeah. So my guess, if I had to predict anything, it's probably got to be a King Gambit lead. Incin goes crazy. We are going to bring Incin. I think we're just going to go with the standard Komo lead, the Komo plan here. We are leaving ourselves kind of vulnerable to Fluttermane, though. I like Amoongus as a lead, though. I think Amoongus is punishing to everything on this team except for King Gambit. So I like that. I think we just go Komo and Ting Lu. I want to bring Incin really bad. I don't think we need him. I think he's like a luxury. I think Ting Lu is just kind of essential for the Fluttermane. So I'm gonna opt to bring Ting Lu. I think that Fluttermane would have been way too obnoxious to deal with. If we didn't bring Ting Lu, we would have had to rely on Incin or Iron Heads, which I'm not doing that. I'm not relying on Iron Head to kill Fluttermane from Komo. So let's get into this one. I've used this team quite a bit, like with the Golden Go version or Fluttermane. I actually was practicing with it when it first came out and I was like really into it. Okay, they led King Gambit. And I thought it was a ton of fun. It was really easy team to pilot and it did well. But yeah, all right, here we go. So right off the bat, I think we can just Trick Room here and switch into Komo. I'm not seeing a huge downside to that play. Because I think what we want to do, like worst case, we're going to take a Heat Crash, right? But that's it. I don't think they're going to Breaking Swipe. I never noticed he had a giant horn on the front of his head. That's a fun one. He's got painted nails too. Gouging Fire. Gouging Fire is crazy. He's a fashionable guy. But yeah, I think we can switch into Amoongus the turn after and just potentially set ourselves up to start Pollen Puffing Komo if we need to, worst case. But yeah, this is just going to be a classic Komo sweep, I think. Ooh, it's shiny too. Let's go. Okay, he crashed onto P2 actually. Wow. I could have just went for Spore. That did like negative damage, dude. Okay, a flinch would suck, but it actually wouldn't be the end of the world. Okay, cool. I think we're just going to go for Iron Defense. Well, see, this is what I'm afraid of, low-key. I am afraid of Terra Fairy Terra Blast because we would actually just get cooked right here, right now. We have no real way to cover that, like, stop that, you know? Like, we'd have to Terra, but I don't want to do that. But I also don't know. They might not be Terra Fairy Terra Blast. Solvest could be on D-Knight. I feel like a lot of the gouging teams do run the AV D-Knight, but there's no way to know for certain here. Let's just risk it. If it's Terra Fairy, Terra Blast, yeah, okay, it's not good. Please don't flinch me. Okay, Recover is lit. They are really slow Gambit. We do have a full HP P2. I was going to say, if it's Terra Fairy, I'm just going to end the video. Like, we'll just cut it. We'll just stop. All right, we're at +2. They're going to Breaking Swipe. No one cares. Yeah, it does negative damage. They don't have, like, Knock Off or anything. That's the big thing here. Knock Off actually really annoys Komo. Like, losing your lefties is it's pretty bad. It's pretty big. All right. I feel pretty good about going to Amoongus here and just going for another Iron Defense. Because then, worst case, I get flinched and I doubt the Heat Crash P2, first of all. Also, P2 is full HP, so like later in the game, we have a trick room if we want it. So this is looking really, really good. But yeah, worst case, I figure we can just Paul and Puffar Como up if we get flinched and breaking swiped. One of them would have to go critical, and if they go critical, it is what it is, dude. That's it. That's the Iron Defense Como away, is crits are a big part of this game. But I think if we don't get crit here, the game will simply just end. There's the protect. Okay, no flinches. They still could crit breaking swipe, but kind of doubt. Also, if they do go for breaking swipe here, it is kind of funny because we do get to just hit them with like a Rocky helmet damage. So that's cool. All right, they're howling. It's fine. I think I can just... I don't want to make contact with the Bulwark guy. So I think I'm just going to go for Body Press into Gambit, and I'm just going to Spore the Bulwark. Because most likely, most of them don't run Protect. Like, I would be... I don't know. It seems... Burning Bulwark is kind of sick, and it is, like, a crazy tool. That, like, it is a cool move that I kind of doubt that they have Protect. So I feel like the Spore is really safe. Yeah, he doesn't even try, so... That guy's sleeping. And this guy might be dead. They don't crit us. That's sick. And we don't flinch. Wow. This game is just going my way, actually. So now the biggest threat to us is Fluttermane. If I had Incin, it actually would have been kind of late. I think we could have got away with no Ting Lu. Like, we really could have. But we have been breaking swiped a ton. Like, Iron Head's going to be like a 4-hit KO on Flutter. And also, it leaves us vulnerable to Sacred Sword and stuff like that if we do Terra Steel. Having Ting Lu just makes our lives better. I still might have the Terra Steel, all things considered. Alright, there's Ogre Pond Water. We still have one more turn of Trick Room. I'm going to go for Pollen Puff onto my Como right now, and I'm going to go for Body Press onto this guy. I think at this point in the game, even if Flutter's last, like no matter what the last mon is, I feel very confident in our ability to just auto win this one. I think it's over right here. Fast asleep. Nice, nice. That would have been a Burning Bulwark potentially there. But that would have also been a first turn wake. It is what it is. Like, sleep is stupid. It is, you know. But now we have a full HP Como at plus 4. And okay, that guy lived. I don't love that, but he did live. I think I'm actually, if Amoongus dies, do I care? I think we just protect him. And then I'm just going to go for Body Press into... Which one would I like to kill? I guess this one can't protect. That one can. I think we'll target Ogre Pond. Because we can just Terra Water too. It's not a huge deal. Okay, wakes up. I saw those eyes open, dude. I was watching his eyes. The heat crash. I could have went for like Terra Water, but I just don't think I need to. Ivy Cudgel. Yeah, you can crit me, but I am still... that was a crit, actually, wasn't it? It was. Okay, it still only did 40 damage, though. This guy's gone. Oh, he lived a plus 4? That thing is mad bulky. There's no way. I'm plus 4, right? Am I going crazy? I'm plus 4. I'm plus 4. Wow. That was incredible. Okay. Well, now I don't feel that bad. Let's just go for... Actually, let's Spore. Not Palm Buff. Spore this guy, and then we'll Body Press this guy. I just want to remove these guys from the table. Watch them double protect. Well, if they double protect, they'd have to actually be protect. Otherwise, they're going to sleep. Alright, Water Amoongus. This was just kind of a stop. This is like a luxury Terra. We don't even really need a Terra. They still have Terra alive too, honestly. Spiky Shield, that's fine. That's fine, dude. I'm all good with that. And there's a Heat Crash. It does negative damage. What's nice about this turn too is that... oh, he died. I was going to say nothing gets KO'd, but something did get KO'd. He just died to Heat Crash. Okay. I was going to say, yeah, nothing gets KO'd, so next turn we can just Spore and Body Press again, or we can Palm Puff kill the Gouging Fire, but no, we actually kill him. All right, is it Flutter? If it's not Flutter, the game simply is over. But I have to imagine that it is Flutter, right? Like, they're holding on to this last mon desperately here. I feel like it's got to be Flutter. But also, Flutter should have probably came in to force me to Terra earlier, so... It's Flutter, okay. That is fine by me. Okay, we are vulnerable now. This turn actually kind of blows. I think we can just protect here. And then... I think we can let Como die. Como has done its damage. Como was a monster. It got 2 KOs. It did what it needed to do. It almost got a third. Ogre Pond lived with 1 from a plus 4 body press, which is like quite insane, considering it's stab fighting. But yeah, we should be good here. Because then we can just follow me. Trick Room, Ting, Luke, and clean up the game. And it's probably over. Como, you did amazing, buddy. I didn't love my Terra. Now that I think about it, I should have just let Amoongus faint. Because he would always take down Gouging Fire with him. I wasn't thinking about Rocky Element. So, but it was, it would have been nice. All right, there's the Horn Leash. Yeah, they want to heal. But this guy's locked into Dazzle. P2 is just going to win the game at this point, too. Because all we got to do is press follow me. And then we're chilling. Did we see if they were specs or not? Were they booster? I think they were just specs. Oh, we got the attack boost. It's fine. I think we just Rage Powder and Trick Room. I think I'm okay with this. What's nice, too, is if they are locked into Dazzle, they'll heal even less from Horn Leech. That I think, like, with the Rocky Helmet, with the lack of healing, they'll probably still be about at the same HP. And then P2 should win this with Ting Lu. Ting Lu actually ended up being, like, a good brain. Oh, wait. They got Terra. I think it's just Terra Fairy. But I don't think that matters. Why did I Rage Powder? In retrospect, why did I do that? Because they are a grass type. That was actually a really bad play. That was just terrible, guys. Don't Rage Powder in front of Ogrepan. I'm not going to lie to you. That was a terrible play. Okay. I should have just Spored. I think I should be chilling here. I'm not sure. Okay, please be chilling. Oh, we're chilling. That was so dumb. I don't know why I did that now. Okay, I really did think they were going to Horn Leech, but this makes it funnier. All right, let's just Palm Puff our P2 here, and then I think we just go for... I could actually go for... No, I think Palm Puff plus Terra Blast feels good. Yeah, this feels good. Because they have to follow me to stop the Puff. But because they do this, Ting Lu can just Heavy Slam. The game's over. We are going to lose two of our Pokemon. It's going to be a 1v1, but we are going to win the game with Ting Lu. We could have won the game with Incin, too. It actually didn't matter what my last Mon was. As long... I could have been the Frostmoth, even. I could have just won with anything. All right, that damage was weak, but it doesn't really matter because Ting Lu will bring down the Judgment with a Heavy Slam. Okay, the Horn Leech was bad, guys. Should have just Spored. Spore was always really good because then, we could have won with Ting Lu. The Sleeping Flutter would have been a little bit nicer. All right, Ting Lu just wins anyways. It was a little sloppy on that turn, but Ting Lu prevails. All right, it's time to take him to the Slam, baby. Where is a Heavy Slam? There we go. Fluttermane cannot live this. There's no way. Judgment will be swift. See you later, Fluttermane. That is 1-0 with Frostmoss, technically. All right, we've got another opponent, Ryu, 218. All right. Frostmoth. Okay. Can we Frostmoth here? Frostmoth looks okay. Like seriously, with the AV here, it does go kind of crazy. Ting Lu looks incredible here. This is probably a Trick Room angle. I actually kind of like Frostmoth. I don't know if we're going to really be able to bring it, though. Because you got to imagine it's Water Foo. I think Double Dark is good here. They don't actually have, like, a way to stop Incin from being annoying. That's the thing. Like, I actually like these three. Just go really hard. They don't, like, Lando Eye is their best Incin check. We can fake it out. It's not a huge deal. I think we have to bring Como, though. No Frostmoth, guys. But next game, I will force Frostmoth. I will just simply record until I find a good Frostmoth game. That is the plan. I will showcase Frostmoth. I have to show Frostmoth. But this game, Frostmoth ain't looking too hot. Even though Como isn't, like, the greatest either, but I think Como just beating Urshifu and being annoying into, like, half their team is kind of essential. I do think Ting Lu, Incin, and P2 just probably win this. But we'll have to wait and see. Let's see what we got here. Ogrepan or Urshifu. Fun fact about my opponent. I don't know who they are. Like, I don't really know them. But last night I was watching Kirofumi. He's a really good Japanese player. He was actually streaming on YouTube. And I was like, you know, I'm going to go check him out. Let's see what he's using, right? So I was watching him. And he actually played against this guy, like, the first game of the stream. It was really funny. All right, I think we just Trick Room and fake out of here. I feel pretty good about that. But yeah, it was pretty funny that I actually saw that Kirofumi play this guy less than 24 hours ago. Like, I literally just watched this guy play. So, and now I get to play them. This turn is just so good, I think. Like, worst case, we do get hit with an Indeedee switch, and then the Surging Strikes kill Ensign. But I think it'll be okay. Maybe I should just switch to Gummo, Loki. Unless this thing's, like, banned or something. Like, look, is it banned or something? I don't know. I'm a little afraid right now. Okay. Surging Strike and Ensign. Oh, they CC my P2. Does he live? Is he banned? Oh, that did negative damage. What? Oh, he's intimidated too. Duh. Oh, that was awesome. That was just really good. Okay, that play had me scared because I thought I would lose Ensign, who I think is good. But, okay. Ensign's going to carry this game. I'm glad they made the mistake of not killing him. I could Dera. I could Dera, actually. What boost do we get? Special attack or attack? Special attack. Cool. I think I'm okay going for Terra Blast into Urshifu and swapping into Gummo. Gummo is a little bit more expendable. I think the two dark types are going to be incredibly valuable. Ideally, the Terra will probably be P2. Most likely not P2. Not P2. It will most likely be Ting Lu, maybe. This guy could also Terra. I guess the Terra is really up in the air. Okay. That's fine. Into what? Ogre Pond. Okay, if they don't follow me, they get blasted. If they do follow me, I think they just... Maybe they don't follow me. What do they do here with Indeedee? They're going to Terra the Indeedee. Huh. That's pretty crazy. Terra Grass. That's even crazier. I'm okay with this, though. I think they are going to just... I think they're going to reverse the Trick Room here. The damage is okay. They reverse the TR. I mean, that's fine. I think that's all good for me. Let's swap into Ensign here. We're going to have to regain our footing here. And let's set up an Iron Defense. We might take a Dazzle here, but I also think that they really need to KO P2. So I think their play is a Helping Hand Ivy Cudgel onto my P2. Don't want to risk a crit. Don't want to risk any of that. So I'm just going to go for a switch to Incineroar in that slot. Because I just... Also, we'll take Dazzle. We'll take Dazzle. Like, let's be real. This ain't Terra Fairy. We're going to eat that up. If they are a Psychic move, though... I'm not thrilled if they are psychic. We wouldn't love that. But I think it's okay. Because next turn, we also just can parting shot and body press, and I feel good about that. They're thinking hard here. They're like, how do I stop Trick Room from going up again? They would draw Ogre Pond. Okay, I could have just set up Trick Room. They go into Urshifu. That's fine. Fine-ish. We're actually going to have to pivot into a non-Trick Room sweep mode. We're going to have to rely on Gummo here, I think. But this is still scary. I mean, we do have double dark, so who's their last mon? That's the thing. Who is the last Pokemon? Alright, they're going to Gleam. Or what if they Trick Room? To predict our Trick Room, what if they just threw the game? Okay. Okay, thank you, by the way. I appreciate you. Let's Flare Blitz Indeedee. And, actually, Loki, what Terra are we? Or Ghost, okay, that's fair. Let's Flare Blitz Indeedee and Body Press it. Like, it probably doesn't have Protect. We just don't want Trick Room to go up, so we just don't care. Yeah, nothing wants to eat this either. Yeah, Ogre Pond doesn't love this. This actually might low-key kill. Flare Blitz might kill, and then we'll just redirect the Body Press into Urshifu, which will feel good. No way. Ah, I lived at the one, darn. It will still faint, obviously, but that's so funny. That worked out highly in our favor. What? That was awesome. That was awesome. What a great turn for us. Alright, Surging will kill Incineroar, but it is what... Will it, actually? Let's see. 112. Nah, he's dead. He's dead. But either way, I think it was worth. We just didn't want Trick Room to get reversed. That was a crazy turn from them. I respect it. Like, I think they wanted Urshifu in. They probably couldn't kill P2. So, I respect what they attempted. It just didn't work out. I don't think it was inherently a bad play. Alright, P2 comes in. The king. The Trick Room king. Indeedee comes in. Now we just Terra Poison. We just go for Indeedee here. Switch deck boost. I don't know if this will one-shot Indeedee, but, like, low-key, let's find out. We just have to double it, because we don't want the Trick Room to reverse. Also, again, it probably can't protect. And if they go for CC or something silly, we will just be chilling here because they'll do no damage to us. If they go for Surging, I do think we'll live with P2 anyways. I'm hoping this one-shots Ndidi, but I don't know. Because most Ndidis are, like, max defense bold, but it kind of depends. This guy also doesn't have, like, a Trick Room Ndidi, so I think it is a little different. All right, let's see what the last mon is here, by the way. Landorus, okay. This is actually really scary that now that I Terra Poisoned, this is a little bit spooky. We actually still could lose this game. We still could. Because Ting Lu doesn't love Urshifu. It does okay into Lando. It does have AV. Like, we could beat the Lando in a 1v1 with Ting Lu. Alright, I just hope this one shots, honestly. Well, it doesn't actually matter. If they dazzle, they dazzle. Ooh, okay. Okay, cool. They were just trying to reverse. Trick Room does have a lot of turns left. That is the one saving grace. Okay, the Rocky Helmet. That's okay. I'll heal that all back. It gets a little weird. They did blow Terra, so Ice Beam is just always going to threaten a KO there. But it's like, do they protect? Don't they? Does Surging KO P2 from this range? Who knows? If they put it in the Aqua Jet range, do we lose? There's a lot of questions we have to ask ourselves here. Okay, so Trick Room has two turns left. They could go for the double protect here. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to Terra Blast Urshifu and body press it. Because I just think it's very unlikely. Oh, they just canceled. I was going to say, it's very unlikely that they protect Landorus. And if we just kill Urshifu, then it ends. And I think Ting Lu can win the 1v1. But we'll never have to know. Okay, let's find a Frostmoth game. All right, so we've got 1336. We've got Scizor. We've got Fluttermane. We've got Dondozo Tots and an Annihilate. Man, Frostmoth looks terrible. I'm not even gonna lie to you here. It looks terrible. Also, low-key Annihilate looks really difficult. I actually might need Frostmoth. I'm not even gonna lie. I actually might need Frostmoth to deal with Annihilate. So I'm gonna lead with Frostmoth Amoongus. And then in the back, it's like P2 Incin, I think. Man, this is scary. I actually think we need Frostmoth to beat Annihilate. And we're just going to have to Quiver Dance like crazy. Amoongus looks great. I'm not seeing any problems with this. Let's lock it in. I actually think Frostmoth goes incredibly hard into the first four. Not great into Dozo, but I don't think it matters. I think we just need it to help with Annihilate. I also don't know what kind of Annihilate this is. If this is like the crazy Final Gambit set, then I don't really care. Then Amoongus is, but then we also need to keep Amoongus alive. We need to keep Incin Amoongus P2 alive to beat the Dozo. This is just annoying. This team is annoying. All right, they got a crazy mess. They got a crazy fit. They're going to leave with Tatsugiri Annihilate. And they're threatening a U-turn here. They're threatening a U-turn. They're definitely just Scarf, are they not? All right, let's QD. And let's go for Spore into Annihilate. Dude, Shiny Frostmoth looks gorgeous, by the way. I love this thing. It actually looks so cool. They're enduring. What are they doing? They're gonna CC their own Tatsugiri? What? This is some insane stuff right now, guys. This is crazy shit. And it's gonna be Toxic Orb. It's gonna be Toxic Orb. I mean, we're sporing that slot, so, like, it's not a huge deal. But holy moly, what the hell is this? That was crazy shit right there. That was so crazy. Oh, my God. That was insane. I've never seen that strat before. I've never seen that one. I've seen, like, the Toxic Orb. I've seen all that stuff. But I've seen the side Parasong, obviously, with the Wolves. But I've never seen the CC Eject Pack Endure Toxic Orb. It's got to be Toxic Orb, right? Like, it's got to be. He's going to sleep, though, which is lit. Show me the Toxic Orb. Show me the Toxic Orb. I know what you are. I know what you are. Black Sludge! That makes it 10 times cooler. This team is insane. This is the craziest thing I've ever seen. I've never seen this strategy before. And Cresselle, it's going to psych up. It's going to psych up. It's going to psych up. We have to just spam Ice Beams on this thing. It has to die. We have to kill it. We have to Rage Powder. If it's Safety Goggles, we're screwed. This guy cooked with this team. Please don't be Gox. It might. I don't think it's Gox because I think it's like lefty stored power. This is awesome. This is like they're not even trying to play the game. They have their strat and they're gonna try to beat you. How much does Ice Beam do? That's not a lot. It could freeze. Psych up. Okay, good. That's step one. We need to stop this psych up. This is gonna be a battle. Okay, we got an Ice Beam. Ice Beam spam. Rage Powder. Yeah. I love this. This is so ridiculous in every single way. This is so ridiculous. All right, Amoongus. Amoongus is shutting this down, though. I accidentally brought the counter to this team. All right, he's still sleeping. Good. Ice Beam, come on. You got to go crazy. Okay, one more. Lunar Blessing. Oh, that's going to wake it up, though. And it's going to heal. I don't really love that. They still have their Terra, too. Why didn't they do that the last turn? That's what they should have done. Okay. I can't let it psych up, dude. Cresselia will end me, dude. I will not win. I think we just have to keep Ice Beam spamming. And we have to Rage Powder. We have to. I hope Frostmoth can go the distance here. I'm afraid they're going to be like Rock Slide or something silly. Okay, that's fine. I want to deal damage to this guy. This is essential. I think hitting this guy with damage... I think this will honestly two-shot. I think Frostmoth is that guy. All right, here's the Terra, though. Is it grass? If we get up Trick Room, though, I think we can stop Cresselia before any shenanigans occur. Let's see what it is. It is grass. That's okay. That's okay with me. They really should just be Lunar Blessing, too. Man. Stored Power, Lunar Blessing. I don't know what their last moves are. All right, here we go. Rage Powder goes off. We're good. We're chilling. What's coming? Please don't be Rock Slide or something silly. Okay, order up. They ignore us. That it doesn't even do half, dude. It doesn't even do half. Frostmoth's the goat. Just canonically, Frostmoth is the goat. That's clean two hit. Okay, so we're gonna Ice Beam this guy again. Oh, but now Frostmoth will faint. But then we can get up Trick Room. I switch to Incin. We Ice Beam. Here's the deal. Switch to Incin. Ice Beam. We're just gonna Terra P2 is how we're gonna win. Okay, so we switch to Incin, right? Now we Ice Beam. It should KO that Pokemon. Worst case, Cresselia comes in, which is fine. Clear Amulet. Oh, no. Inner Focus. Oh, God. What is going on here? Oh, no. That guy's dead. See, I was hoping that wouldn't be the case, but they're probably just going to Rage Fist anyways, right? Yeah, lit. Okay, I'm okay with that. This is still just a battle, guys. This is a battle. Okay, we go into P2 here. We're going to have to Terra Poison Trick Room. Clamulet was not what I wanted to see, but it's what I respect it. It's definitely what it was going to be. Okay, so we have to Terra Poison. They're inner focused, though. Why are they inner focused? That makes zero sense. I don't think we have to Terra Poison. I think I will, and we will just set up Trick Room, but I could Terra Ghost as well. That wouldn't be terrible. And then we have to fake out this guy, though. He's starting to get crazy. He's starting to go kind of crazy over there. Okay. Maybe I should have Terra Ghost. Maybe I do need Incin Alive, low-key. I wonder if they're... So they're clear Amulet. They're definitely oblivious. Like, or unaware. They're not oblivious, so... That is a little annoying. We don't have our boosted hits. Oh, man. This is so stressful. They protected? Okay, that doesn't matter. Is he gonna, like, U-turn or something crazy? Not that it really matters. They should just CC Incin. Why are they not Defiant, though? I really don't get that. They have Taunt? Are you serious right now? Okay. That's not chill or good. I would argue. We gotta hit him. That's fine. They're just gonna EQ. Are you serious right now? We have to go critical here. It's plus two though. This earthquake's gonna hurt. P2 actually really clutched that one. P2 did great. Taunt. If we crit here, do we win? I'm thinking maybe. Like, actually. If we crit here. I don't know. I think crit maybe, but... I you know, at the end of the day, I can't really be mad. I just can't. I really can't. Like, this guy cooked me. That was insane. I'm not even mad. I'm really not mad. Wow. I think we should play one more after that one. I think we'll do one more. All right, we've got Scott 697 here. Oh my gosh, yes, it's time. It's time. It's time. It's time for the queen. It's time for Frostmaw. I'm not seeing too many punishes here for Inson. I think we go Amoongus for sure. And then I like just a regular Ting Lu. I'm a little worried about... I'd rather bring P2. I'd rather bring P2. I think P2 is so good. I'd rather just bring P2. I feel like Urshifu low-key, it's not like a huge issue for the team. Because you have Amoongus, you got P2, you got Como. But like low-key, Urshifu with a lot of special attackers does seem really spooky. Let's see how we approach this one. All right, Urshifu plus Glaceon. Now, I'm loving this lead for us. Okay, I mean, I hate that my brain is so... I played in the GC like 2 weeks ago, and my brain is so messed up from the GC that like I'm always thinking like, is it Covert Cloak, dude? I'm always like, are they Covert Cloak or Shifu? Because like, I swear to God, there's just so much... Like, Covert Cloak is so good, so real, and having to deal with always thinking about it is like almost impossible. It's not, you just simply can't. Okay, come on. I think this is okay though. I think this is really good because he is intimidated, so Terra Fairy or Terra Water does feel good, but I am afraid of this freeze-dry guy. Okay, Scott, that's amazing. I love you. Thank you for that withdrawal. Incineroar the Anxious, that's fine, that's fine. I mean, like, it's not super awesome, but it's okay, because I think we can Terra, and we'll be okay. Especially now that they they just detected, okay. That's good, that's good. Fake out. They also might not target the Frostmoth. They might just want to kill Incineroar, to be honest. Quiver Dance time. Frostmoth is going to go big this game, I can tell already. Amoongus Switch is good and free. I think we want another Quiver Dance, ideally. So let's Quiver Dance. Let's Quiver. And let's switch to Amoongus. Because if they do Surging Strikes Incin, they're just going to lose the game. If they don't Surging Strikes Incin, that's fine because we're Terra Water. Like, I don't expect them to CC. And if they do CC, they're at minus one. So every single move that they press with Urshifu is good for me. How is he still faster? Frostmoth is so slow. Okay, we needed a second QD for sure. All right, Terra Water. Okay. It's got to be going into the Moth, right? It's got to be going to the Moth. But I think this is good. Let's see. Let's see what they do. We're slower than Urshifu still, though. I don't love that. I really don't. Terra Water. Oh, Frostmoth. We also have a Citrus Berry, by the way. So we do have some HP recovery in the future. I really hope they don't... Oh, I guess... What do I want them to do? I guess I want them to fake out the Moth. All right. Is this into the Moth? They know they have to kill the Moth. Yeah, it is. I could have parted. Oh my gosh, that did negative damage. 127 to... It did about 20 damage. Not bad. Not bad at all, honestly. And now we eat our berry. How much does a Frostmoth tear up? I'm going to calc this. I need to know, because this would actually be really huge. Because we could just go for Spore and kill Inson, and that would feel really good. Alright, I don't know my Frostmoth calcs. How do you even spell it? Frostmoth. Okay. I don't know what the special attack is in this thing. Frostmoth is 12. It's max defense. Oh my. Okay, we're running out of time. Incineroar. I like how there's not even on this calculator, there's not even a calc for Frostmoth. It does about 94 to Incineroar at plus 1, which is a little unfortunate. But I think what we can do here is Quiver Dance again. And then just go for Rage Powder. And I think that's okay. I think we can make that work. Okay, that's awesome. He could be like goggles or something, but worst case, he can't do anything to Frostmoth anyways. Like, even with a knockoff. Alright, now we outspeed Urshifu. Now we're at plus 2. We're ready for a Frostmoth sweep. And I know that Incineroar will faint now. They go for knockoff onto Amoongus. Okay, I respect that. They knock off our helmet. A respectable behavior. Do we eat? Okay, I'm going to Terra Blast Incin for sure. Now we're plus 2. I think we eat Close Combat. It's at minus 1, right? I think we eat this. We're max defense Frostmoth with max HP. This is as good. We're not bold. We are modest. But this is the best we can simply do. Look at how small the moth is compared to these big, burly, strong Pokemon. And then their Frostmoth's just floating there with this little water head on. Okay. Terra Blast, Incin, out of here, dude. Out of here. This is definitely a one-shot. Oh, yeah. That's a plus two. That's a plus two, baby. Better than plus one. Okay, and they're just going to go for CC into the moth. It shouldn't kill. Wow, that did quite a bit. But that's okay. That's okay. I'm chill with that. I think we actually, like, get a little of HP out of this. I don't know. I think maybe we should have just Rage Powdered in retrospect, but it's okay. I think we got a little. I think the risk of crit was not worth it. We should have just Rage Powdered, but that's okay. Glaceon's here. I think Terra Blast is stronger. We might as well start hitting Glaceon before it does something silly. We're just gonna Rage Powder this turn. we're just gonna Rage Powder. Alright. Who do we have? We have Incin and P2 in the bag. I like our odds here a little bit. Especially if we can start getting KOs, then this guy's just stuck at minus one attack, minus defenses, so P2 should be able to win. That did so much damage. Holy moly. I think low-key we're able to kill our Shifu soon. Freeze dry. Okay, Captain Moongus is out of here. Like, how much are we doing with Ice Beam? We're at plus two. They're at minus two. I think we KO. I think we seriously KO. It depends how much bulk they have. No, I don't think it matters how much bulk they have. We go Incin. I think we seriously just kill this thing. They're probably just going to protect here, to be honest, but that's okay. Huh. I think we one-shot our Shifu with Ice Beam. I just also want to see it happen, you know? Like, I just want to do it. I want to hit him with it. Nothing wants to take a plus two Ice Beam. Oh, let me tell you that. Man, this is a Frostmoth sweep. Okay, that doesn't matter. We're just going to do free damage. Do free damage here. Okay, I could have got the third QD. I don't even think we need it. I am going to probably... I think I should target Urshifu with... There's, like, no way he can live. Like... He has to be max HP. Like, let's say he's max HP. There's still an 87% chance to KO. So, he'd have to have a lot of special defense. But he is probably Mystic Water. That is my fear. Let's do it. I just want to see it happen. Like, honestly... I don't care if this is a slight misplay. I want to see this happen. Because I really think... usually they're like max special defense is the thing. Like 236. Yeah, they would have a good chance of living then. I don't know. Maybe I should have just went Maybe I should have just killed the Glaceon. I'm starting to second guess myself, but this is just going to kill. Watch. Oh no, he lived with one! He's Sash! Oh my god, he's just Sash. Okay. CC, oh no. Frostmoth takes it. I should have. Oh my gosh, he's just Sash. Frostmoth live! Not even with the ice scales? I thought maybe with the ice scales and the plus two special defense. Frostmoth, no. I think this is all okay though, still. I think P2 can clutch this. Because we killed Urshifu. That's the big one. He's out of here. He was Sash the whole time. I was like, no way he live at one. That's crazy. That's unfortunate. But no, it was just Sash. Now I wish I killed the other guy. And knocked off, I guess. Okay. This is okay, though. Because now, wait to go to P2. And they have Ninetales. Okay. This is so good. Outside of one slight issue. And that issue is Snow Cloak. That is the only thing stopping us from... And freezes, I guess. But we just keep spamming Flare Blitz and we'll always thaw, so... We should be good. Trick Room. And we're just going to Flare Blitz Glaceon. Yeah. We just need to kill this thing. Oh, here they come.
They're doing, like, negative damage.
No, please. Okay, we didn't get frozen. We did miss. Ninetales did negative damage, by the way. Ninetales was a joke there. But yeah, negative damage. All right. I think I'm allowed to just double this guy. I just don't care. It needs to die immediately. Please. It could protect. It could protect. Low-key, the Glaceon was the one dealing the damage there. The Ninetales did nothing. Okay, we missed Flare Blitz. That's okay. We missed two of them. Who cares? This one's going to hit. Yes! Thank you, P2. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, P2. I love you, buddy. Thank you. Ooh, I wonder if it was Bright Powder. I almost wanted to knock off to see, but I also don't want to knock off because if I do get frozen, that is not chill. All right. I think we win. Yeah, we can just Terra Bass Flare Blitz. I think this thing will die. I'm hoping. I'm a little nervous, but I think it should die. Oh, yeah, it's out of here. It can't. This one doesn't have Snow Cloak. This one has nothing to dodge this move. See you later, Ninetales. GG. All right, I think that was a good Frostmoth game. We got a crazy Dondozo game. This video is going to be a little longer than average, but that's okay. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. It was really fun playing with Frostmoth. Again, the creator of the team down below, link to their Twitter, link to the document they made about this team with the paste. They wrote a huge what is this? 12-page document about the team, how they built it. This team is sick. Shout out to them for winning the tour. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.